Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students. In the last lecture, we have also did the first order reaction as well as the rate law for the first order reaction. But now we are going to do the rate law for zero order reaction. So let us see how can we derive it. As we know that the reactant gives us product, and as the time increases, the concentration of reactant goes on decreases. So for that thing, I would consider the reactant A, which is giving me the product. So I am considering a reaction in which A is giving me product. So as the time increases, the concentration of reactant goes on decreasing. So this is nothing but the rate of reaction. So for this, I could write the rate of reaction as rate, which is equals to minus concentration of dA divided by dt. The minus symbolizes that the concentration decreases with respect to time. And now, since we are talking about a zero order reaction, so we could write the zero order reaction in the form of rate law also. So let us see. According to rate law, rate is nothing but K into concentration of A, that is reactant. But since it is a zero order reaction, so the experimental value, that is the value of X component, in this case will be zero. So let us see what else we can do with this thing. So now the equation can be written as rate is equals to K. But we have also got the rate earlier also, which is this one. So I would mark this equation as equation 1. And the equation that we have got right now as equation 2. So therefore, equating both the equations 1 and 2, we'll get, so equating equation 1 and 2, we get minus dA upon dt is equals to K. So I can do the further process like minus dA is equals to K into dt, and I'll shift the negative sign to one side, that is dA is equals to minus K of dt. But this equation is a differential equation for a zero order reaction, but we have to integrate it. So let us see what happens when we are going to integrate it. So integrating the equation, we could get this thing. But integration should be in a limit, that is a lower limit and a higher limit. So I would consider when the time t is equals to 0, the concentration of the reactant A would have been A0. And that when time t is equals to t, then the concentration of reactant would have been AT. So since we know that integration of dx is nothing but x, so similarly the integration of dA will be A, but with a limits, that is with the upper limit when A is AT and when a lower limit when A is A0. Similarly, we can apply limit for the time also. So we could get when time t equals to t and when lower limit when t equals to 0. So after doing this equation, what we could get is, instead of a, we'll write the upper limit as at minus the lower limit, that is concentration when it is at minus the concentration of reactant when it is a naught is equals to k, again when upper limit is t and the lower limit is 0. So we'll get finally as at minus a0 is equals to minus k of t. So what we are going to do is, now we are going to relate with the rate constant and the further part, that is the further parameters like a0 and at. So let us do it. So by arranging the above equation that we have got, we could write the equation as kt is equals to minus of at plus of a naught. That could be written as a naught minus at. Simple. And this equation can be finally written as k is equals to a naught minus at divided by t. So this is the final equation that we have got, or we have made a relation between the rate constant for a zero order reaction. I hope you have liked this video and you have got to know that how to derive an equation for the rate constant for a zero order reaction. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you will share with your friends too. And please don't forget to subscribe to EKIDA channel. Thank you so much.